Exactly. Now, anyone who's lost weight knows that losing it is just half the battle. Keeping it off can be an even bigger challenge.
But a Brisbane bloke, Terry, has done just that after overhauling his life and dropping a staggering 100 kilos. Now, he's sharing his steps to success.
At 185 kilos, Terry knew something had to change.
I was eating unhealthy, zero exercise. The only vegetables I ever ate were chips.
He was too big to walk, uncomfortable, pre-diabetic, and suffered from high blood pressure.
I got to a point in my life where I realised I need to do something because I was just killing myself.
Sick and tired of being sick and tired, Terry jumped on Google searching for answers.
Now I came across the CSIRO Total Wellbeing Diet. I saw that it was high protein, low GI combination of food, and I knew it was time to make a change.
In just 2 years, Terry lost over 100 kilos.
The difference between what I used to eat when I was so big and what I eat now is absolutely phenomenal change. I eat so much more healthy food and as little processed as possible, but I still enjoy a nice, healthy, balanced diet.
So what's the secret behind his life-changing success?
So it's very important that the food that I eat now is sustainable. I even have ice cream every night because, hey, ice cream, and we need to enjoy ourselves.
As part of his lifestyle overhaul, Terry walks an hour every day. He even outwalks his dog. And what's even more impressive is Terry has managed to keep the weight off.
I completely, not just changed my life, I saved my life.
CSIRO Total Wellbeing Dietitian Pennie McCoy joins us now. Morning to you. So many people struggle to keep that weight off. Why is that?
Look, weight loss is a long journey. It's a hard journey and it's not easy, but it's about finding sustainable approaches that can help people keep those habits that are going to support their weight loss in place. Something like the Total Wellbeing Diet has really put a lot of research into how to help people lose the weight but also keep it off in the long term.
Okay, let's go through the day. Start off with breakfast. What's best for us?
So what we're looking for here is a really good start with some low GI carbohydrates and some good quality proteins. We're looking at some rolled oats, some fresh fruit and some serves of dairy with yogurt and some milk, and always kicking off with a little bit of coffee if you do enjoy it as well. So it's a good start to the day to keep your energy levels up.
Okay, what about lunches? This looks fantastic.
It's amazing, this meal. This is a vegetable chili con carne. So you're going to get your protein here from the plant-based protein sources of kidney beans and legumes and so forth. But something coming into these winter months, nice and hearty, you can cook ahead of time. Planning is key to success as well, to staying on track with your healthy eating as
well. All right, and dinner?
And dinner. Dinner can be really simple. It doesn't have to be a complicated recipe, but something like some grilled fish, chicken or lean meat is a good source. This one here is some salmon with a nice little salad as well. Good source of protein, healthy fats and oils, and keeping you feeling fuller for longer.
Can you have any dressing on the salad?
Absolutely, yes. Looking for a good balsamic and a nice olive oil, and that'll get you healthy fats and oils as well.
Okay, and obviously vegetables, not just salad as well.
Veggies as well.
Can you do a good baked vegetables?
Absolutely,
and things like
some
that?
Roast vegetables would be delicious. So any of your favourite veggies coming into the winter months, thinking pumpkin, thinking eggplant, zucchini, tomatoes, really fill up that plate with lots of good quality vegetables.
And it's amazing what you can do with cauliflower these days, isn't it?
Absolutely. Cauliflower rice.
Yeah. Instead of rice, you use cauliflower.
Absolutely. You can get creative. And, you know, the one thing with healthy eating, it doesn't have to be restrictive. You can have huge volumes of food. It's just about getting the right balance and right portions of food with your meals as well.
Now, some people find it hard not to snack.
Yeah.
And over there, that looks like a snack page.
Delicious snacks. Really encourage people to have those snacks between meals as well to keep that appetite managed and those hunger levels at bay. We've got some really delicious yogurt and fruit options here, which would be your healthy snack options. And then some healthy indulgences with some chocolate raspberry bliss balls, which are delicious, hit that sweet spot and prevent those cravings from
hitting. I think you're the first dietitian to ever recommend snacking on chocolate.
Oh, delicious. Look, they're so good, aren't they? You've got to have those favourite foods in your diet. Otherwise, if you have a really restrictive approach, you're less likely to stick.
What about ice cream? Okay.
You can include in ice cream occasionally as well. So it's about getting those indulgences in the right portions and at the right time.
What's
for
the definition
you as well?
Of occasion?
Yeah. Occasion. You can have one indulgence a day.
What's a day?
Absolutely.
I love your definition.
Yes, exactly.
You beauty. Pennie, come back anytime.